Hello, fam. We will ship no ambrosia before it's time. We got lemon, see yellow pack. We got the grape, I got the ginseng, and I got the big old Death Eater. All gone. Man, it's good to be alive. Make sure you catch the show. For me, Facebook can't really see the box, but this is a box full right here. People that's been supporting the journey, I've been getting busy, and I got more to bottle, but I just didn't do it. I'm gonna age a little bit more, so of course we're gonna start off with our water. Now I'm gonna be sharing with y'all the benefits of water, although we all should know it. You know, it's kind of good to kind of review. But I'm hearing different figures. Some people say that you should drink half your body weight in ounces. So if I weigh about 170, that means I need to drink about 85 ounces a day. That's nice. About 85 ounces a day. So half your body weight, then convert that to ounces, right? Or, you know, just put ounce on the end of it, right? So take half your weight. That's how much water you need to drink in a day. Not all at one time throughout the day. That's the water. Come on now. Get your head start. Text somebody later on in the day and tell them, stay hydrated. Because a lot of us are suffering from dehydration, as well as some of us are suffering from some of the poisons from some of the tap water that some of y'all are drinking out there. I try to stay away from tap water as much as I can. But I want another one. As y'all can see, I brought another gallon on deck. I like distilled water, so whenever I can get it, I got it, especially for my brewing. I like distilled water for my brewing. I don't want no unknowns in my water, right? Drink it up with me, fam. All right. So now, what we gonna do? We are going to toast our ancestors. Ah, give me a second. It is important for those of y'all that drink at least my ambrosia, right? My kombucha, my June, right? My green tea and fermented. My green tea and honey fermented. It's important that you always have an extra glass with you when you open it. This is why. This is a lie. I don't ferment it. You know what I'm saying? I want you to get the live piece because that's what's most important. Most of the stuff we eat is dead. And as one of my elders told me a long time ago, if you consume death, you become death. If you consume life, you become life. So this is one product that you take alive. So I don't know how this is going to react because it's, I just bottled it last night. Well, as you can see, it's ready. It's ready. It's ready to come out. So this right here, it's the purple cap. This is the grape. I decided on a grape. I was thinking between wild berry and grape. After sampling and after sending samples around, I decided to do grape. So, alright, that wasn't that exciting. But hey, it is what it is. Alright, so this is the grape. So we're going to toast. Let me look at it first. Alright, looking good, baby. It's holding together good. Alright, we on popping. Alright, so first, give a shout out to the creator by whatever name you choose. Call that creator. We call that energy. Even though we already know it's present, we acknowledge that energy that's all around us. We acknowledge the energy that's in the drinks that we drink, the water that we consume, that's in the food that we eat. We call on that energy and we celebrate that energy that's flowing through everything. Right? And we want to be able to be conscious enough to acknowledge this energy on a daily basis. So we salute this energy, this creative force, this creative power, this creator. We salute it and we call it into our presence and we say Ashe. From there we move to our personal ancestors. Here we toast our personal ancestors. We toast up and lift up those that lifted us up when we was too big to lift ourselves up. We toast those that held us when we couldn't hold ourselves. We toast those who walked for us when we couldn't walk ourselves. We toast those who fed us when we couldn't feed ourselves. We toast those ancestors that spent the time with us that we needed. We toast those ancestors that taught us how to ride bikes and taught us how to drive cars. We toast those ancestors, those personal ancestors who had a personal and powerful impact on our life. We remember their energy. We remember the blessings. We remember the lessons that they gave to us. And we toast them and we say, Ashe. Right? So, your personal line, you go through it now. If you got anybody that you wanted me to toast, like I said, you can forward it to me on Facebook or you can send it to me on my timeline, on the timeline for this video, for YouTube, because I always check it. I'm keeping names down. We toast right now to the present moment. Today is Kujichagulia. We're toasting Kujichagulia and we say salute. We say Ashe. You know what I'm saying? Kujichagulia, the day of self-determination. We toast it and we say, Ashe. Last but not least, we toast our children, our children's children, on to infinity. Right? Because everything we think, say, and do affects our children. You know what I'm saying? So we want to make sure that we're thinking right and we're acting right so that we can leave the world for them better for them than it is for us now. That's the goal of nation building. You want to make sure that your progeny is able to move on. So we toast them and we say Ashe. But of course this is not last. There's one more. I want to send a toast out to anybody out there that may have special issues that they want to toast for. So we just called our creator. We just called our ancestors. We saluted the power in the moment. We saluted the power in the future. Now we want to guide that energy to what we need. So for anybody out there with any special needs, we toast. We say Ashe. So I'm sending shots out to one of the viewers, Vern Loves. She's going in for surgery, so we're going to toast her here on the journey. And we say Ashe. We pray that everything works out. We toast so that everything works out. We say Ashe, Ashe, Ashe. Beautiful day. It's nothing like being surrounded by your own product, I'm trying to tell you. Alright, so on YouTube, I'm going to be breaking down the importance of water. We're going to really look into water. I'm going to talk a little bit about the eye-shaped force that flows in the water. We're going to talk about palm oil. We're going to talk about coconut oil, not all today. We're going to talk about the black seed oil, the importance of some of these oils and getting them into our life and getting them to where we need them to be, to getting our life to where it needs to be. Of course, we're going to continue talking about that ambrosia and fermented foods and how we need to start incorporating them into our lives. So those of you that's on Facebook, please catch up with me and subscribe to my channel on YouTube so we can keep building, because we're moving up slowly but surely, right? We've been on YouTube a long time, right? So we're going to finish this drink. Now it's time for me to get to my show. All right. So, thank you, Facebook. All right. Sorry, fam. Hey, how y'all doing, right? So, as usual, we need to go on and do our little discussion, and I thank y'all for joining me. But as y'all see, I've been busy, got a whole box full over here. All right, you know what I'm saying? Silver cap, ginseng, Justice League, lemon, lime, and ginger. Purple is great. I don't got no original in the box. This bottle right here, the big gigantic bottle right there. That's that Death Eater. Somebody ordered a gallon of Death Eater. So I'm going to make sure they get what they need. So we're going to go through what we need to go through, fam. Because, of course, today is Kujichagulia. And I'm trying to keep these up under 30 minutes. You know what I'm saying? Because I promise. And I'm working hard trying to do that. But y'all know my mouth just won't stop. I can't stop it. I'm trying to stop it. My mouth just won't stop. It can't stop. It won't stop. It don't stop. Right? So, let's get busy. All right. So now, of course, let's get this Ashe flowing. I need some more water. Drink some more water with me. Come on now. I know y'all busy. I want some more water. All right. After you take the cap off, you know, you can store it. The cap back on. You know, they got those special top things you could put on to kind of seal it so that the gas will stay in and it'll just stay bubbly. Alright. Let's do this. I had looked up something for y'all this morning. You know, because it constantly on my mind what we're going to talk about. I think tomorrow we might do a little something on water. I'm not 100% sure yet. But depends on what's in the news and what's going on. But I wanted to finish sharing some of the day stuff with y'all. So I found some more information on the day names. The day is Kujichagulia. The day names for the day are Kwabena, which I am. Abana, the female name. Of course, self-determination is the principle in English. The Maori principle is justice. And the hermetic laws correspondence. The color is indigo. It's like a dark blue. We talk a little bit. We might get into some of that. Alright, let's take our stuff first. Y'all know we experiment with the black seed oil. Alright. I'm gonna take this one last. I'm also experimenting with that palm oil, right? The red palm, African red palm oil, right? I do two things when I buy this, right? Supporting black folks, African people, African stores all over, almost in every city, at least I think. And then on top of that, I'm supporting my health. Now, what's up with the palm oil? Palm oil is full of beta carotenes, but we're going to talk about that a little bit more, right? And it helps with a lot of things. You know what I'm saying? Including energy. Because it's a natural fat, right? And it's not that high cholesterol, poisonous fat that they be putting in the foods right now. This is that all natural, off the tree. My wife gonna kill me. Not that bad of a taste. It's also good to cook with, right? You can fry with it. You can add it to your soups. You can add it to a lot of stuff. Real good for you. We're going to talk about this, all right? But watch what you got on. Because like you see, I got on my white pants. It will stain you up. Ain't just a regular stain, it's a grease stain, you know, oil stain. That's hard to get out. All right, so now I'll do a little bit of coconut oil, a lot of the same benefits, but just a little bit different, right? Yeah, I'm piling it on. All right, come on now. Now, also, you know, I told y'all about the weather with this, right? Making my brewing kind of hard here. Making my brewing kind of hard. This is real weather sensitive. You see that? Alright. Start melting as it get warmer. Good for energy level too. And you know, like I said, I need stuff like that. Since I'm doing the warrior diet. Alright. Helps sustain my energy levels throughout the day. So I'm about to find a way to get me a smaller one of these and take it with me when I'm feeling my little, you know what I'm saying? But actually, the struggle during the afternoon is not even food, it's more of sleep. You know what I'm saying, y'all? Those have been catching, staying up with me, you know that I sleep a lot, right? So I call it the Harriet Tubman disease. All right, that's that black seed oil. We're going to talk about that too. All the rage on the internet right now. All the rage. All right, but we're looking for things that help us operate at an optimal level. Being on Kujichagulia, which we're going to talk about in a second. All right, bear with me. Akan day names, creative acts, and their meaning. Akan day names and their meanings. I am reading from Akan day names, creative acts, and their meaning by Obini. Akan day names and their meaning. For a long time, most of us have thought and accepted The fact that Akande names like Kwesi, Kwame, Akua, etc. are names given to male, female, born on particular days of the week without actually knowing the actual meaning of these names. This is because so much of our culture, which constitutes customs, language, food, ceremonies, identity, etc., has been lost due to westernization. I stumbled upon a book that explains the meaning of these names and the significance, which I thought I should share with all of you. Before I get to the meaning of these names, let me give a brief overview of a few important points. The Akan calendar has 7 days in a week. Now, I have heard that some Akan calendars have 8 days in a week. Now, I know some of y'all are like, how you do that? And Imani is considered the first day of the week. Saturday is also a day observed as the Sabbath in the traditional typical Akan communities. And we got to ask, was that before the Western incursion? It is also worth noting that the word Akan does not only mean to tree-speaking tribes, as Ernestly thought. Akan is derived from Akani, which meant, when broken down, means first light, as in Kani, first, or Kania, light. Akan, therefore, means first primate people and includes other tribes like the Ga, Awe, the Gomba, Mosai, etc., etc. Oyan, now these are some nice words, hold on. Oyan, Kopan, Kwame, the great name of God. The word Ikopan is what has been corrupted into Onyankopan. Each syllable signifies one of the characteristics of God. O is the shortest and most basic name of God in Akan. It signifies his, her, universally completeness and perfection. This has something to do with the sun. O also signifies a being or agent capable of achieving a purpose, as in Onipa, Otumfua, Obada, Onyansafo, etc. Aya, which can be written Ya with a Y-A, Ja, J-A, or E-A, meaning being or agent, has been corrupted to Inya or Nya, which connotes wisdom, as in Nyanza. Me signifies a self-consciousness personality. Me also means I in Akan, and could mean satisfaction, as found in the word Omi, satisfaction. Ko means one and points to the oneness of God as a being without a rival. Pon means great and depicts the supremacy of God as the sovereign of the universe. This idea of greatness appears in the words like Obrimpan, Odupan. All right, so we're going to get to the day. I got to do yesterday. All right. Kwame Koyame, the Akan day name for God. So even God has a day name. Akan day name for God is Kwame, which was originally Koyame or Koyame, can be etymologically broken up into the syllables Koyame. Ko means life, as found in Kosua, egg, which when written properly is Kosuya, literally life, water, being, signifying water containing life being. That's that water, y'all. Su is the ancestral form of Insuwa, water, or Koto, crab, translating to empty life because of a crab's hollow nature, emptiness. Ya, E-A, or means agent. Ya, Aya, or A, means agent, being, or father, as in Agaya. Me means satisfaction, or I. Putting the syllables together, Koyame, translate into satisfied father of life. It is for ease of pronunciation and assimilation of the sounds that Koya became Kwa through contraction. Hence, Kwa means father of life, wisdom, or the life being, or as they say another one, Kwa, creator. the light being signifying source of life. Qua is therefore also one of the basic names of God. Interestingly, all of the Akan male day names begin with Qua, as will be explained soon. So I'll come back to the other days. We are going to do Oya on Monday, and then we'll do Tuesday, and we'll finish up on this throughout the week. Duoada. I almost said it. I ain't gonna give you no Moja. Corresponds to the day on which Qua created the ferment. This is yesterday. This is Moja. The Akan word for ferment or sky is Yu. We or Yu Mu, which means whim, and is now being corrupted into Duo to mean cool or cold. We ferment itself is regarded as being cold. Another word used in translating ferment is nitrumu, which connotes expanse. Doada Yuda means ferment day. That is the day on which Qua created the ferment. Doada Eduada Wida or Yuda, which is shortened form of Qua Yuda or Qua We Wada or Koya Yuda, means Lord of Life, Ferment Day, and is the second day of the week. Kuojo or Adwo, therefore, means Lord of the Life Day. So those of you born on the Moja, you are the Lord of Life Day. That's what that means. Banada, Kwabana or Abana. So we on this day. We'll move into this day and then we're done. Banada or Biniada or Beda, Kujichagulia, is the third day of the week and the day on which land was made to appear. Bay is the root word for Bia, which means place, location, or land. In Akan, Binada therefore translate into Land's Day or Day of the Land, Bida. It is for this reason that fishermen do not go to sea on Tuesdays in Ghana. Kwa ba nada or koya be nada, which has been shortened to Kwabina, means Lord of Life's Land Day. Abana means Land's Day. Alright? So those of you born on today, on a day, Kujichagulia, kings and queens of the land, yo. Alright. So now let's go knock this out. So today is Kujichagulia, right? Day of self-determination. Yesterday we talked about drama and how drama breaks down unity. But also, I want to focus a little bit on how drama can break down your self-determination, right? Getting tied up in foolishness, right? Because this is drama I'm talking about. Because, you know, drama can't be avoided. Drama is exciting, action type thing. You know, drama is what unfolds in life. You know what I'm saying? Any issue that may happen in your life can be dramatic. There can be drama involved. But the issue starts when we start allowing ourselves to be overtaken by over-dramatization, right? So drama in itself is all right. But what happens is we start burning up energy when we start allowing ourselves to get caught up in something that has been over-dramatized, right? See, and this is what those that want to hold you down understand. So they keep drama going. You know what I'm saying? They keep it interesting. They keep it, you know what I'm saying? They want to keep you up with what's going on with the Great Pumpkin. They want to keep you up. They want you to chase and see the drama, the over-dramatization of what's going on with the Kardashians. Why? Because when you're focusing energy in that way, the energy that you need to create your life is going that way rather than in the way that you needed to go. So when it comes to Kujichagulia, when it comes to this day of correspondence, when it comes to this day of justice, you know what I'm saying? When it comes to this day, right, we need to be focused. We need to be firm like the land. Abana, right? Kings and queens of the land. This is our day to be firm on us moving towards where we want to go and where we need to be, rather than allow other people to kind of distract us with bullshit, right? Don't let Facebook distract you with the bullshit. Don't let them fake you. Don't let them fake you out, because, like, yeah, it's important to keep up with the news, but do you have to over-dramatize it? Do you have to buy in to the foolishness that they sell it? No, you don't. See, because you have a greater purpose. You have a higher purpose. We got work to do, right? Like, I'm doing my thing with Ambrosia. I don't know what thing is you working on right now, but you need to focus your energy on that. Why? Because the world is waiting for it, and the world needs it, right? But we waste our energy allowing people to get us caught up into their dramatization. Not only just their dramatization, but their over-dramatization. It's not that serious, right? You need to focus your energy. See, in any combat sport, in any competition, if I'm going against you, the goal is for me to get you to burn out of energy before I do. If I can distract your attention, where your attention goes, your consciousness flows, right? So if I got your attention on my right, I can hit you with my left. I need you focused on the center mass. Like in some martial arts, they teach you to focus on the center mass. You understand what I'm saying? Right up in here, right? Because this is the truth. But if I got you over here on my fist, right? Because if you monitor the center, it'll tell you what's coming if you watch the body, right? And it's the same with life, man. Focus on the center mass. Focus on what's important to you. Don't get caught up. Don't allow your energy to be drained and wasted, all right? Kujichagulia, be self-determined today. Be determined to fulfill your goals. Be determined to stay on your purpose, right? Be determined to stay on your system. You see me every day. I'm trying to not only talk about this, but I'm trying to demonstrate it for you, right? I cut out the workouts and stuff, but I'm still doing them. I cut out the showers and stuff, but I'm still doing them, right? Because I'm trying to cut the time down, right? But the issue that I'm trying to say to you is, listen, get your system, get it together, and move in it. Because if those of you that heard the interview that I did with Brother John says that when you make something a habit, right, you move towards mastery. So now you don't have to think about it. So there's less thought energy going into that thing, and you can now create other things in process, right? You could be deadly with your focus, but now you be doing something and you so good at it that you can actually open up to other creative alternatives. But many of us, we're allowing our mastery to be caught up in drama. We're being turned left, we're being turned right when our path is straight. Alright? So this is Brother Tim, and I'm saying peace and thank you for joining me. You know what I'm saying? Thank you for joining the toast. I'm gonna finish up this bottle. You know, I'm gonna say something for my wife. I'm gonna go toast it up fair. Alright? So this is Brother Tim, and I am out. Thank you for watching the video. I want you to subscribe. Click the bird right there, the fiery bird. And I also have a special video just for you right there. And for those that want more information about gye-nyame Journey, go to our site. It should be right about there. Peace.